Hey there, YouTube. So here's level 5 in World 3. This one's bang for buck. So, this one's actually a long one, and it also is two parts. Also has our first 4x multiplayer part, so this one's a big one. As you see, we needed the red fist sticker here, so it is a two-parter. First, we have to run past some fire laser enemies we just passed by. Trying to think of something here. So yeah, so lots of bombs here, as you guys can see already. Lots of explosion. Reminds us of Jalapeno back in Loving Planet 2. Oh, sorry, 1. I don't know why I said 2. So yeah, basically, first run through is pretty easy. Make sure you don't miss that. I just want to grab the bombs here first and check out this area. There's some sticker, some prize bubbles right underneath this little ramp. Very easy to get, you know, you won't miss it. Okay, so yeah, come back into this hidden area here. You know, an easy couple, 4 prize bubbles. Just a bomb right down the center and you got 4 right there. I'm just heading up this ramp here. We got 2 of those fireball laser guys now. Advice, just dodge them, I guess. Don't do that, though. You guys might die if you aren't lucky. To be honest, I just did a lucky dash there and made it across. So right like that, perfect. Okay, now there is an area up here that you can reach with these bombs. You're expected to do it on the second playthrough, but see, you can't do it on the first playthrough, so you can just go ahead and grab those prize bubbles there. You want to head over to the next area. Okay, so here's the next area. I just wanted to clean myself up. I think I did that a couple times. I like to be nice and clean there. So, don't miss those prize bubbles in the back, also. So now we gotta grab into one of these bombs here on this hook and swing over these flying electric arms of doom. Don't miss that prize bubble either, right on top. Not very hard to miss. That was also a very nice grab. Okay, so anyways, I'm gonna miss one right here, so you're gonna see it soon. Right after these, I just don't want to die here. I think maybe I can get back up. I can't, so just jump across. There's a prize bubble right up there. I do miss it, so I'm just pointing up to it right now. I will show it to you in part 2. All you have to do is jump off the bomb folder things there and not fall into the hole, and you should have got it. So, for this area, just let the fire lasers do their work and clear off the bricks, I guess you could call them. Clear them out of the area, and you can get 2 easy prize bubbles. So that was a fail. Okay. And just like that, you can grab the second prize bubble. And then you can just get them to open up the final path. Just like that. And of course, I died. Okay, so now here's the next area. The bricks here blocked your path. Just stand here. There you go. Just let them burn it down. Then let them burn down the ones in the center. Kind of tilts the whole area. And if the rocks fall down. Yeah, don't stand there. You'll either die from the rocks falling on you or the fire beam on you, so just keep your distance. And now we're heading into part 2 of this world. So yeah, this one's a big one. There we go, and now we're in part 2. Not part 2 of this level playthrough, but part 2 of the level. So now we got our sackbots back in the picture. Right? And don't miss these prize bubbles up there in the corner. All you gotta do is jump onto one of these cages here. Okay, so now we have Clive telling us about this Jack in the Box that makes all the sack bots attractive. So, some sexy sack bot mama. And they're going nuts. So, basically, use these little sack in the boxes to lead the rest of the path. So we can just keep on moving and make it easy. But that was terrible. Make it easy for them to run across. So that was also terrible. I apologize. It was so bad. Okay, so Sackbots run across. So the other ones burn into flames somehow. Don't know why. Okay, so here we just gotta run across this little electrical rotating platform. Pretty straightforward. And you can hit the other switch there, but they won't be able to make it across. Yeah. I'm just gonna grab that prize bubble first, right across on that cage there. Just give me a second. So I'm gonna get that prize bubble. Don't miss that. So all you gotta do is just hold it down once it's in a good position, and all the sack bots can run across the other side. Just like that. But yay! Now. Okay, so now we gotta get them over here. They can all just fly off into the tube because they're in love. Now they're in love with that other sack bot. Aha, see you later, buddy. And that was also extremely terrible, I apologize. Okay, so here we can grab these two prize bubbles at the top before we head into the multiplayer area. So now we're gonna take a leap inside. Go to our flashy multiplayer screen. Okay, so this one is with four players. And basically, it's a hot potato where you take your players and you kind of have to pass this bomb that's taking over each obstacle and make it to the end to get all the prize bubbles. Obviously, the last one's the hardest. So the first one's the easiest. You can do that with two players. And they just throw me over to get those easy two prize bubbles there. So I just cut it because we were going all over the place trying to get this thing done. So I just put it straight to the parts that worked. So here is a... when we get the three prize bubbles, and we do kill one of our members in the process, but you know, sacrifice is needed. So we get that one. Then we're gonna go ahead for the two player. Took our two player spot to realize that he had to not throw the bomb and just sit there. So there you go. Somehow some guy tried to join the game with four players already, so I was kind of confused about that, but oh well. So this last one here. So you gotta be quick with the hot potato and just throw it over to the other side, and that's it. So you get your last prize bubble in the multiplayer area. So there's everybody's names, do a little dance, and I head it back to single player. Okay, so now I just hit up these little bumpers, Mega Man style bumpers, just like one of my levels. Oh, that's a good idea to add to my levels. Okay, so now we're just making it through these two areas. We're back with the sack bots here. Just make sure you didn't miss that prize bubble in the box. So you are going to see a red switch in this next part right here. Don't hit it until you get the key first, because it does launch a bomb out and whack you in the face. So now we can just take the bomb, jump across, and don't die. I'm just gonna clean myself up here. I just hate being all dirty. And yeah, pretty much it. You can hit another thing, get it one goes up in flames somehow, and all the sack bots fly over. I'm just checking for, you know, prize bubbles. Potential prize bubble spots. So this one's pretty straightforward. Just do a jump past those. That was so bad. Oh my god. Let's not talk about that. Okay, so just throw one of these bombs across and get another female sack in the bot, and the other one goes up in flames again. Then we got some terrorists in there or something. I don't know what's going on. When I first saw it, I was like, what the hell? Why is it in flames? But that's what they decided on, so. So anyways, enough mumbling. We got another prize over here. Very easy to get. Just use the bumpers there. And another sack in the box to feed our poor souls up tubes. So there's another couple going up the tubes. And now we are heading to our final destination soon in the level. So we just have to pass through these electric rotating rotors. Wow. Failed there the first time. Okay, so basically just don't fail the first time like I did. So these rotating wheels are... Oh my god. Okay, don't fail the first time or the second time like I did. All you gotta do is kind of stabilize yourself before and after each wheel. And basically, once you do that, it's pretty straightforward. See, I just kind of stabilized myself there and I'm free to move on. So yeah, it's not... Oh my god. Okay guys, I'm sorry. Please lol at me and the comments as much as you want. I deserve it. I know. So, we got this little guy here with the happy face, and there we go. We just cross his path, and we cross all the hands here, and we got another little monster swinging around his, oh, that's a giant mouth. That's kind of cool. And we got another monster here just swinging over his arms. Okay, so I did not know that we had to let go of the bomb, and I suicided myself for the sake of the mission. But you did not have to do that, so my bad. And of course, I died there. How terrible. Easy bumper shots, just, you know, go straight up. Okay, so now we're doing our dash from the end of the level here with the morph faces and we build bodies here. Just keep on running, you know, you can't really lose here unless you're with multiplayer. If your friends that get stuck behind, or right there, I'm sorry. You can die right there. And wow, they actually start back up. Okay, so got all the prize bubbles with all the guys here, just need to clean myself up. So we got those four, and you see the red fist is right there. So now we have the red fist, which you guys now can go back and play the levels that you missed. Sorry, the part twos now that you're going to need. One for this one, and one for the previous episode I put out. So here's up to 70, and the rest you will see in part two, when we have to play the level over again with the red fist. So guys, see you in part two.